Happy Sunday, or whichever day you are watching this vlog. Welcome and welcome back. It is good to have you here. So let's jump right on into it. So I have this huge chunk of broken mirror, super duper heavy, which is no joke. Look at the thickness. OMG. Had no idea what to do with it because I'm afraid to even attempt to cut it and cause it to break. But then a very bright idea came to mind that said, Kay, you don't have to cut it, just work around it. And that is exactly what I'm gonna do. I'll probably just remove the little piece right there, right over there. Hopefully it comes off without breaking the entire thing, fingers crossed. And if I'm successful with the cut, then I'll be making a beautiful wooden abstract frame. So stay tuned. So I wasn't successful in cutting the mirror, but nevertheless, I got it sorted out to a point where it can still be used. So I broke off the pointy end, and my cousin Maurice used a nipper to nip away the other ends that wasn't needed. Thanks, Maurice. Thus, the rugged edges you see here. But that will be no problemo. All those edges will be concealed shortly. I have these pieces of recycled board. They are actually from pallets, very lightweight, which is perfect because, again, the mirror is super duper heavy. They will be used as the frame for the mirror. So what I'm gonna do is clean them off, then measure and cut them. This is the frame so far. And this is the back. So all those little stubs you see in the back is still help anchor down the mirror in place to prevent any sort of movement after installation, because as you can see, the mirror does not fill out the frame. And did I forget to mention that these boards already came with this beautiful curved design you see along the edges? I'm loving it. It just adds a whole lot of character to the frame. And for my backing, I'm gonna go ahead and use a piece of cardboard instead of Solitex board because I'm trying to avoid the extra weight, given that this thing already weighs a ton. A little tip on how to clean your mirror if you run out of glass cleaner is to damp a piece of paper towel with rubbing alcohol and wipe it down. And then wipe it dry with another piece of paper towel. I guarantee that your mirror will look refreshed. Thank you. So this is how the back looks when it is installed. And then the very last thing I have to do is to install some screws right here so that I can hang it. But that's it. Thank you.